Okay. To start off with, here's a quote I'm sure every one of you must have heard, right? You guys have heard of this? Yes or no? Just give me a show of hands. Have you heard of this or not? You have, right? It says morning shows the day. Now, what does that all mean? So, people say whatever we are as a child, it's kind of a reflection of what we will end up being when we grow up. So, if that were all true, wouldn't it be really easy to kind of regulate this whole idea of mankind and things like that? Pretty easy, I'll tell you. So, when you're young, you let all the Zuckerbergs and Gates grow up, and whoever is supposed to take the other side, let me not name them, you just get rid of them, right? So, problem solved. That doesn't happen. So, we're left with this dilemma as to what are we supposed to do when we grow up. So, the climber spoke about maybe, okay, so you want to do engineering, do you really want to do it? But you're not sure about it. So we don't know what do we really want to do. So there's something called finding yourself. We talk about finding ourselves as to what are we supposed to do when we grow up. That's kind of a biggest question that we have, like literally for every one of us. Okay, I don't know why it doesn't seem to work. Okay, so this is something I really love to say. It's somewhat like I travel to 44 countries just to find a bit about myself. And why do I love saying that? It's because that number kind of suddenly grabs attention. 44 countries is kind of a big number, I get that. And I love saying that a lot. So let me say what my story looks like. So there was this point of time, I was back in school, and I grew up in this small place called Duliajan, which is in Assam. I was literally like any other kid or any other child you can think about. My life revolved around going to school in the morning, coming back, getting 2 to 3 hours to play, and pretty much that's it. I used to study in the evening and my day used to end. And this routine kind of went on for as long as I could remember. There was no change in it. It was literally the same thing day in and day out. And we talk about that one moment which changes us all. For me, it was never like one event or one big thing which happened that changed me. It was never like that. But I realized one thing. There was this monotony in my life which I was not really happy about. I was really upset about the fact that I was literally doing everything which everyone else around me was doing. And it doesn't end there. So when we talk about going to school, doing the same things, the way we push out rewards or maybe appreciations, it is not something which goes to everyone. This is something which is really, really not a balanced like figure. So everybody doesn't get appreciated, everybody doesn't go out there to shine, right? But literally if you look at it, everybody else is doing the same thing. Like literally, you might be scoring 90, it doesn't really matter, I scored 88. Like, okay, for 2 marks you're trying to, 2% you're trying to tell me that I'm not good enough. So I was not really a big fan of that whole thing. So long story short, and that's when something happened within me. It's like I wanted to change. I wanted to make sure that for some reason this thing doesn't need to go on. And like, how do I explain it to you? Okay, coming back to it. So yes, I was literally like everyone else. There was nothing which made me special. There was nothing which made me who I was. There was nothing which said, Ankur is so-and-so. And that really upset me. And there was this question which used to come in my mind. Now, let me talk about the first time I was on the road. It was like maybe I was 12 years old when I was on the road for the first time. Now, traveling alone is really a fun experience. Like, it was different. It felt good. Obviously, I didn't have a clue. I didn't have the slightest hint that going on the road alone for the first time would change me, like profoundly. So I started traveling when I was 12, and by the time I was about to graduate from school, I had been on the road for quite some time, like good enough time. And this was the point of time. Like, you guys must be in class 11th and 12th, right? So yeah, same point of time. People start asking you questions. So what are you doing with your life, Ankur? So where are you going? Literally, all they want to know is which are the exams you're sitting for. That's the only thing that they want to know about. And it's just a sugarcoating, like, okay, what do you want to do? No, I don't want to know what you want to do. I want to know which exams you're sitting for. So that's the question. And literally, are you telling me I was 16 years old and you're telling me, what do I want to do? I don't know what I want to do. I really don't know. I mean, maybe I still don't know what I want to do. So Yeah, I didn't have an answer for it. And I had to find an answer to it. And the question was this. How would I really enjoy spending my life? And did I have an answer? No, I didn't have an answer. But there was something which had snapped, something which had changed by being on the road alone for a long time. And the change was this. By the end of class 12, I realized I was not going to join the race that everyone around me was going to join. I was sure of that. And I had the courage to make that choice. I said no to mainstream engineering courses that I had. Everyone else was supposed to go. And it's not just me who had changed. People around me started changing. When I talk about people around me, at that point of time, it's my parents. So one of the biggest make it or break it for us in our lives are our parents, right? So if my mom and dad would have said, no, Ankur, this is like crap. It doesn't happen. You're supposed to go do engineering. Maybe I would have done it. But yes, they had changed along with me. They were not afraid to let me go out there and take my chances. That's exactly what had happened. Can somebody move the slide? One more. Okay, so coming back onto the track, right? We're talking about traveling. How many of you have heard of this? How many of you have heard of this in blogs, or this was at a point of time viral on social media? How many of you have heard of this? Just give me a show of hands. Literally almost everyone. Okay. So it says, why should we drop everything and travel the world? Like, fascinating, like really fascinating stuff. Everybody wants to do it, but I'm sure everybody also knows this. It's not something which is that easy. It's not that straightforward. It just doesn't happen that one day you drop everything and I want to go travel the world. Where do you get the money? It doesn't happen. So, now, when we talk about traveling, you might have heard of this again and again, that the whole idea of finding yourself, and one of the best ways to find yourself is to go out there and travel. It's something that all of you have heard, but what I'm going to tell you today is not about the same old idea of let's go out there, we'll find ourselves, but an idea, something which is a bit different from the whole story. I'm here today not because I have all the answers. I'm here today because I have a simple question, and the question is this. How many of you out here today have at some point of your life felt that I need to find myself? Like at some point, maybe right now, maybe when you were younger, or maybe, I mean, it's not necessary, it's only the students. I'm sure even the teachers might have felt it. Have you guys felt that I need to find yourself? Just give me a show of hands. Just give me a yes or no. So a lot of you. And it's the same for me too. I felt I needed to find myself. Now, traveling did help me, but it also showed me one thing, and that is, whatever I found out about myself, it's not something new. I mean, it's not something which traveling gave it to me. It's something that I had always known. So what I'm talking about is, whatever we want to do, or what I'm really interested in, is something that I have always known since I was a very little kid, right? It's just that as we grow up, stakeholders start coming into our lives. It's our family, our friends, expectations start coming in. So we get a very blurred image of who we are, or what are we good at, or what do we really want to do. That's exactly what the problem is. We don't listen to our inner conscience. We don't listen to who we are. We just go out there. We are in a race trying to find something. It's just all bizarre. It's just, you don't even know why you do that. You just go out there and you're like in a race. Like, there's no reason why would you be doing this. Because you know the person next to you is doing it, and he knows the person next to him is doing this. It's like a cycle which keeps going. Maybe your parents grew up like that, you are growing up like that, you'll push your next generation like that. It's just going to happen. It's just a cycle which is never going to end, right? Okay. So traveling also taught me one thing. The whole idea of self-discovery is a myth. Why? I already said, it's because we know what we want. We know what we are good at. And we have known that since we were very young. So is that a positive thing, or is that a negative thing? When we talk about finding ourselves, is it a positive thing, or is it a negative thing? Can you just, okay, if it's a positive thing, just show me your hands. Do you think it's a positive thing? And how many of you think it's a negative thing to just find yourself? Is there anyone who thinks it's negative? Truth is, it's actually negative. Why is it a negative thing? Like, moment you say, I am out there to find myself, you literally mean that you're lost. Or you literally mean, I'm not happy. So you don't live in the present. You are just out there trying to find some missing piece in your life, which would suddenly make your life more meaningful. I mean, does that happen in reality? No, it's not something that's going to happen. You're not finding anything. So what does it do to us? It just makes us a jumper. We jump a lot nowadays. We jump between jobs. We jump between relationships. We jump between different versions of what we believe we should be and what we should be doing. So we live our life confined in a zone that is what we are supposed to be, what we are supposed to be doing, where I should be going, instead of living in who I am, what am I doing. So we don't live in the present anymore. We live in a, like, it's a kind of vision of the future that I'm looking at. So that's where the thing comes in, right? You need to realize that. It's about, okay, here's the thing, right? That, okay, let's not do this anymore. Let's just focus on what I really want to do. Like, what am I even doing right now? Why am I even standing here and giving you this talk? So those are the questions which should come into your mind. Start questioning the present. Stop living your life with the whole idea that somewhere down the line, I'll go out there, I'll find my calling. There's nothing like a true calling that we have come to know. There's nothing of that sort. Everything you want to know is all there within you. All you need is to just look a bit deep down inside you. Now, of all of this, okay, I just forgot about the presentation. I just realized that. Can you just move it? Okay, can anyone take care of this? Okay. Just keep going. I don't even know where exactly am I supposed to. Just keep going. Okay, a bit more. A bit more. Yeah. Okay. Just stop it. So, sorry, I just forgot about the presentation. So, coming on to this. Okay, where was I? Now, how does traveling even come into this whole picture? How do I relate traveling? So yes, I talk a lot about I've been to this country, that country, and everywhere. Like, how does it even relate to the fact that I'm saying finding yourself is not something which is a positive thing? And this is where it comes. When you travel alone, when you're out there alone, without people that you know, without your friends or your family, you put yourself to the test. There's a lot of things that you need to tackle. There's a lot of questioning that you do. You realize what are you good at. You realize your strengths. You realize your weaknesses. And when you have the peace and calm to just be at one with yourself, you start hearing your inner voice. Life is very easy when we are young. Life is really, really simple when we are young. I'm not scared to tell you what I like. I mean, when I was young, I could have told you what I wanted to do. But as and when I grow up, people start giving me additional unwanted things that I don't really want to know or don't really need to know. By the time I'm maybe 18, 19 years, I'm lost. And that's what traveling brings back to you. Traveling brings back that whole essence of what being you is all about. Traveling brings back those days wherein you could easily open up and question, what do I want to do? So that's what it's all about. Traveling is not about going out there and finding yourself. Traveling is just a aid or a tool that you can use in order to just question yourself. So, what are the other things that you might possibly require to figure out life right now? One of the biggest one is grit. So, when you take the road less taken, you would realize that, okay, not a lot of people are out there. Not a lot of people do things differently. You would be questioned. You would be ridiculed. People around you will make a fool of you. Like, they'll literally laugh on your faces. Think, what the hell is wrong with you? What do you think you are doing? That's where you need grit and courage. It's very easy to give up. It's very easy to say that, okay, I have had enough of it. I am not seeing anything happening. Let's just do what everybody else is doing. That's where you need to stand out. That's where you need to make sure that you don't fall back. Over time, you would realize that, okay, you're at a place which is way better than everybody else. So life is pretty much sorted, right? So as we have said that clear, that traveling is not just to find who you are, I would still urge young people to travel. not because you have to find yourself, but there are a couple of other things in your life which would obviously make your life on this planet more meaningful, and traveling gives you pretty much a lot of it. One of it being, traveling connects you with the nature. Traveling connects you with the cultures. Trust me, you would not really know how many slices of cultures are out there, how many different perspectives exist to look at just one simple thing. It's so, so varied, you would be like, you'd stand in awe and wonder. It allows you to connect with people, places, moments, and all of it serve a different purpose in your life. We talk about the whole idea of getting out of our comfort zone, but it's a whole different story when we get out of our comfort zone and we go and settle in someone else's comfort zone, because you're not the one who has the upper hand at that point of time, but there is someone who has the upper hand. It teaches you a lot. It teaches you about settling. It teaches you about settling down at a place when it's not your forte, right? That's one thing. Another thing which traveling does is it helps you bring out that empathy that you have within you, the empathy for global suffering as well as social issues. It's very easy. As long as I don't see something right in front of me, I would not really relate to it. It's very simple. You see some calamity hitting some corner of the world, you'd maybe like, oh, this should not have happened for like 10 minutes and you're done. When you travel, you get to see how people are doing. You get to see the reasons behind how human life is so fragile. I remember this time when I was in Lahore, and I remember going to this war memorial and thousands of names scribbled onto a wall of people who fought me and you and they died. Maybe there was a reason, and the reason being they were our neighbors and we didn't have a way just to kill them all, right? That's a reason. But there is also a reality, and the reality is what was the cause that they were fighting for? There was a cause that they were fighting for. I want to know that cause. I want to relate to it and empathize with that cause. It's not necessary that I need to agree with it, but yes, it is necessary for me to know that cause as to why were the people ready to actually lay their lives, right? There's a reason. Now people ask me, why Pakistan? Why should you even care about things like that? It's as simple, right? Before you go and bomb someone, at least try to know them. It's not necessary that everyone else is doing something wrong and it's only us who are doing something right. And these questions only come when you go out there and you see it for yourself. Another part of the story where traveling changes you, it's truly a humbling experience. I mean, in the comfort of our own small little cities, in our schools, we might be scoring 90%, we might be scoring even 100%, right? Like, we think we know it all. We think we know so much. Like, literally, there's no one else. I might get into IIT tomorrow or whatever it is. We think we know it all. But then you realize that when you're on the road, you know so little about this world. You know so little about people around you. The way you connect to people, the way you can make connections with people on the road, how can you make sure everybody else perceives you for who you are? So that's the whole idea of it. Traveling changes you as a person. It's not out there to go give you an answer of what are you supposed to do. It's not out there to give you an answer of what is Ankur supposed to be doing. Traveling was not about that. It was never about telling you that, okay, it was never about telling me who I am supposed to be. It was never about telling me what I was supposed to do. It was just a tool for me to find out, yes, am I doing the right thing? So towards the end, it just boils down to this. We said that straight, right? We said that straight, that traveling is not really going to do the same thing that we had expected. It's not about finding yourself. But yes, the change that traveling did was this. It helped me grow myself out of the regular person that I was into growing into something who's more mature and of a worldly creature. Traveling pushed me to my limits to make sure that I do my part in order to make the difference that I want to see. It's about growing into a worldly creature wherein you can be an inspiration for the millions of others who are out there facing something which you might have faced at a point of time. And yeah, I lost track of the presentation. These are just a couple of pictures from, like, so that's with Malala, and this was back in G20. So, couple of things. So, pretty much that's it. Thank you.